Minimum spec CPU time. We're comparing today my i5-8400 that's been in my minimum spec system for a while now. We think it's getting a bit too slow, so we're now looking at the i7-8700 to see, does that improve things? Let's get into it. If you're new to this minimum spec system, for a while I've had this box. It's an office PC that I've converted into a low-end gaming machine. I had to upgrade the power supply, chuck some more RAM in there. It's only got 16 gigs of RAM. And I have been trying different CPUs and different GPUs. It started off with an i3. That was not good. That was just a 4-core 8th gen i3, no good. But we upgraded to the i5-8400. And that has been the minimum spec recommendation from me for a while. And remember, when we talk about minimum spec with Star Citizen, in my opinion, we're aiming for 30 FPS at most. Most of the time. There'll be points when you definitely drop underneath 30, but hovering around the 30 mark. So we are looking to see, does adding the hyper-threading of the i7-8700 improve things? Because the i5, I think, is now not a great recommendation. So we're adding hyper-threading. So instead of being 6 cores for the i5, we've now got 6 cores, 12 threads. There's a little bit more cache, which in theory helps. We know from testing the AMD X3D chips that cache really helps. And also, in theory, there should be a bit of a clock speed boost. So all-core clock on the i5 should be around the 3.8 mark. On the i7, it should be 4.3. But here is why you don't necessarily want to go out and buy an old office PC and convert it. The motherboard and the BIOS and everything is so designed for kind of low power situations that it won't allow the i7 to use enough power to boost past 3.8, 3.9. So the results you're going to see in this are not even actually the full potential of the i7 if you had one of these on a proper motherboard and not one of these crazy things. You would get better performance. But what this video does highlight is how much does hyper-threading really help. So we'll get into it, testing 1080p. The GPU is the 1660 base model. That's my recommendation for around the 30 FPS mark on the GPU. Let's get into some testing. We'll start off, as always, in Louisville, the place where I do a lot of my testing. But actually, on this occasion, Louisville isn't a great place to test this system, or at least the CPU. You'll see here, we've got an improvement with the i7-8700, but actually quite a lot of the Louisville run is bottlenecked by the GPU. So this doesn't really show us how much of an improvement you'll get out of this i7, but it is a good start. And we are now with this minimum spec system hovering around the 30 FPS mark. Arc Corp though is a much better place to test because we are completely CPU bound all the way around. And you'll see quite a large improvement in performance. 1% lows are better, but also just the average is significantly higher and again above the 30 FPS mark. Next up, we've got the Orizon Rooftop. We normally use this to use the clouds to test 4K, GPU, all that sort of stuff. But here we are actually CPU bound in both these results. The i7 is nearly GPU bound, but not quite. And again, you see a good improvement in CPU performance in this scene. This is the toughest scene, I think, on CPUs that I test. Maybe one of the toughest parts of the whole game. It's the render scene where you're looking out across Orizon and it's absolutely hammering the render thread. And you'll see here that we are seeing a big improvement, especially in 1% lows, but we are actually under 30 FPS. But to be honest, I would expect that from this particular scene because it is really, really brutal. Quantum travel, this in theory isn't that interesting result because we're mostly GPU bottleneck, but the 1% lows are significantly better on the i7. So maybe that's hinting at something there. Next is space. We're still actually CPU bound here. There's not really much going on for the GPU to do, but the results are basically the same. Maybe a small bit in 1% lows improvement on the i7, but you're not going to notice that. One of the things that's interesting about all of this testing is that we've got hyper-threading, and that does that. Is that what's making the difference? Is it the cache that's making the difference, or is it the hyper-threading? Because the clock speeds are basically the same, they're both boosting to around the 3.8 mark across all the cores for the i5 and the i7. If we turn the hyper-threading off, we will see how much that is actually helping. So we've got Louisville first of all. You'll see here the results are basically in between. So you're seeing a bit of an improvement because of the hyper-threading and a bit of an improvement maybe because of the other parts of the chip, the cache potentially. If you then look at Area 18, you'll see probably a clearer picture of actually what's really going on. You see that the i7 on its own with the hyper-threading on is way out in front, but the i7 with hyper-threading off is basically matching the i5. And again, that probably hints that actually the hyper-threading is actually what's doing most of the work here. The extra bit of cash is making a tiny bit of difference, maybe, from these results we're seeing. But actually, hyper-threading on this lower-end chip is making a significant difference to the performance that we're seeing. So, what to make of this CPU? Well, I'm going to put some more footage up of me doing a bounty hunter mission, and you'll see that generally, again, we're still around the 30 FPS mark, which is pretty playable for Star Citizen. There's definitely going to be drops below 30, but on the whole, is playable. So, we are going to stamp this CPU with minimum spec approved by me, at least. I think what I'd love to do now is round up my Intel picture. So on the Ryzen side, we've tested all the CPUs. We found that really, again, the 3600 is about the minimum spec that you want to go in there. The 2600, I think, is a bit too slow at this point. I'd love to test Intel 10th gen, maybe 11th as well, but I'd love to test the i3 and i5 on the Intel 10th gen. A lot of people will be on those CPUs or be looking at that and thinking, well, what are my upgrade paths? So yes, that is probably where this is going to go over the next few months, trying to round out the minimum spec CPU picture and then put it all together in one big video again for a minimum spec 2023 video from me. So if you are interested in any of those things, technical specs, PC requirements, PC performance for Star Citizen, subscribe, like this video if you liked it, come to Discord and talk about all this sort of stuff, and also become a member if you'd like to support with money, which is very helpful. Thank you very much.
Bye.